Gila na gila, le hegan o rahala. Gila na gila, the honic ar slí an oignis. Brightening brightness, alone on the road, she appears. Crystalline crystal and sparkle of blue and green eyes. Sweetness of sweetness in her unembittered young voice, and a high colour dawning behind the pearl of her face. Ringlets and ringlets, a curl in every tress of her fair hair trailing and brushing the dew on the grass, and a gem from her birthplace far in the high universe, out glittering glass and gracing the groove of her breasts. News that was secret she whispered to soothe her aloneness. News of one due to return and reclaim his true place. News of the ruin of those who had cast him in darkness. News that was awesome, too awesome to utter in verse. My head got lighter and lighter, but still I approached her, enthralled by her thraldom, helplessly held and bewildered, choking and calling Christ's name. Then she fled in a shimmer to Lochra Fort, where only the glamoured can enter. I hurtled and hurled myself, madly following after, over caches and marshes and mosses and treacherous moors, and arrived at that stronghold, unsure about how I had got there, that earthwork of earth the orders of magic once reared. A gang of thick louts were shouting loud insults and jeering, and a curly-haired coven in fits of sniggers and sneers. Next thing I was taken and cruelly shackled in fetters, as the breasts of the maiden were groped by a thick-witted boor. I tried then, as hard as I could, to make her hear truth. How wrong she was to be linked to that Lazarus swine, when the pride of the pure Scottish stock, a prince of the blood, was ardent and eager to wed her and make her his bride. When she heard me, she started to weep, but pride was the cause of those tears that came wetting her cheeks and shone in her eyes. Then she sent me a guard to guide me out of the fortress, who'd appeared to me, lone on the road, a brightening brightness. Calamity, shock, collapse, heartbreak and grief. To think of her sweetness, her beauty, her mildness, her life, defiled at the hands of a hornmaster sprung from riff-raff, and no hope of redress till the lions ride back on the wave.